Hello everyone, I'm Guillaume Lestrelin from CIRAD. I'm presenting this experiment on the co-piloting of territorial development on behalf of a large collective composed by researchers from Tunisia, from France, as well as agents from the Tunisian Ministry of Agriculture. So this is an ongoing project and I will not present any major scientific finding. The idea is more to reflect on our current experience and the challenge that we are facing while trying to initiate a change of policies, a change of practices in regional planning and natural resource management. For several months now, participatory workshops are being organized in 5 governorates in Tunisia. These workshops aim at allowing local actors to voice their visions of development challenges for their communities and to identify actions that could meet these challenges. The workshops are made possible thanks to the intervention of a new kind of expert within the Agricultural Administration of Tunisia, the territorial facilitators. These people that you can see in the video, they all have a background in agricultural engineering and they were also trained in participatory approach. So they are able to facilitate focus groups as well as larger meetings, and they mobilize a diversity of tools to represent and discuss information and to help people prioritize issues and make collective decisions. The workshops are a starting point for setting up territorial committees, a new inclusive local institution composed by representatives from local communities elected in every village of the intervention sites. On the video on the right, you can see territorial facilitators leading a meeting where people in one village of the KEF intervention site are electing their representatives. The territorial committees are also composed of representatives from municipalities, from the civil society, and from the private sector. They also include local innovators and young leaders, which are selected by the above actors. The territorial committees will be involved with producing and exchanging knowledge on rural territories. They will be involved with citizen debate regarding issues and priorities for territorial development. They will conduct integrated planning and they will pilot the implementation of action and they will monitor and evaluate realizations and the impacts. Ultimately, we envision that these committees will provide enabling conditions for a social learning process involving, on the long term, a diversity of actors from different sectors concerned by local development issues. All this is happening within the framework of a larger initiative, the PAC program. It's a 6-year initiative which intends to break up with established top-down sectorial approaches in regional planning and natural resource management in Tunisia. And by doing so, it intends to strengthen the capacity of local actors to organize and to adapt to climate change. The program benefits of a large fund, investment fund of more than 50 million euros. For investments toward sustainable management of natural resources, economic development of marginal rural territories, and the improvement of local governance. And the program is intervening in 6 different sites located in the north and the center of Tunisia. The work of territorial facilitators has allowed for a significant level of participation among local communities. For instance, during diagnosis activities undertaken in 2019, the total number of participants to events organized by the project amounted to more than 2,500 individuals, including 1/3 of women, which is not so common in rural Tunisia. The diagram on the left gives you an idea of the participation per intervention site. You can see in Bizerte, for instance, that out of a total of 4,500 residents, some 665 individual residents participated to diagnosis activities. Another achievement is related to the identification of key development stakes by local communities. During a series of workshops where diagnosis results were debated, we also organized votes for prioritizing the issues to be addressed primarily by the project, by the state, and also by the communities themselves. In the 6 intervention areas, around 3,600 people voted to select their key priorities. In turn, these priorities now constitute guidelines for identifying, discussing, and planning future development interventions. Finally, another important achievement has been the negotiation and the elaboration of conventions of partnership to be signed by 7 municipalities and the Ministry of Agriculture. And this paves the way for an institutionalization of the governance model. And more generally, this is a contribution to decentralization. So nice achievements. By way of conclusion, the work that we are undertaking within the PACT program is an ambitious proposal. We put forward facilitation and inclusive institutions as key elements for addressing local tensions and potential state-sociality conflicts. It's a change of paradigm, it's a change of practices for the public administration, and we try to impulse new forms of collaboration between research and development in Tunisia. And ultimately, the PAC program is a contribution to the decentralization objectives established in the National Constitution of 2004. But there are significant challenges ahead. We are facing issues with the recognition of the key role of territorial facilitators by regional agricultural administration that is traditionally more technical. So the role of facilitator is not easily understood by the hierarchy. We are facing also issues, or we might face issues in terms of the recognition of the legitimacy of territorial committees. Legitimacy recognized by the public administration or the municipalities. There are possibilities that territorial committees might be used as an excuse for intervention or without participation. There is also the question of the legitimacy of the territorial committees relatively to the local communities. Another challenge is related to engaging actors beyond the agricultural sector at the central and local level. The plan that we intend to design with this framework are beyond the agricultural sector, so we need to involve other ministries, we need to involve their regional branches, we need to involve key private sector actors as well. And finally, another challenge, which is also quite important, is to keep the momentum and to deal with tensions between the expectations for actual investments, expectations from the donors, from the local populations. And so to manage this tension between these expectations and the need to give sufficient time for social learning, for envisioning new collective futures, and so on. All right, thank you very much for your attention. I hope the presentation will raise comments, and I hope that we find opportunities to exchange on these comments during the 2 weeks conference, and even later. Thank you again.